Good afternoon, children. Welcome back to Social Science class. In previous class, we all discussed the introduction of Dutch and the trading centers of Dutch. Today, we are going to discuss why did the Dutch decline in India. Today, we will discuss decline of Dutch in India. English. See children, first cause for decline of Dutch in India. First cause what? Dutch. Clash is what? With the English. In this, Dutch were defeated. Defeated by English. Understand children? First cause means what? Dutch clash or fought with the English. In this, Dutch were defeated by English. This is the first cause for decline of Dutch in India. Second one is Dutch were competition. Understand children? Second cause of decline of Dutch in India. Dutch were not able to face the English competition in India. And Dutch were South Asia. Understand children? These are the three causes for decline of Dutch in India. First one is Dutch clash or fought with the English. In this, Dutch defeated by English. Second one, Dutch were not able to face the English competition in India. And third one, Dutch were turned their attention towards islands of Indonesia. Europeans of English. Dutch doctor. Who came to India? Dutch doctor. English one came to India. They were came to India in the year 1600 to 1947 Common Era. Understand children? English word came to India in the year 1600 Common Era. Understand? When they were came to India in the beginning. In the beginning, they were. They were followed peace trade. Peace trade policy. Peace trade policy in India. Who? English. English also called as British. British also known as English. When they were came to India in the year 1600 Common Era, in the beginning they were following peace trade policy in India. After that, they took the advantages of the deteriorating political situation in the India to establish their political supremacy. Understand? They were took the advantages of political situation in India. When they were came to India, they were beginning, they were followed the peaceful trade in India. After they were took the advantages of political situation in India and they were established their political supremacy. After they took the advantages of political situation in India, after they developed and also they were established their political supremacy in India. Understand children? 1600 Common Era, they were came to India. When they were came to India, which purpose? Great purpose. In the beginning, they were followed peaceful trade policy in India. After this, they took the advantages of political situation of India. Understand? And also, they were established political supremacy in India. They took the advantages of political situation. See here. After that, English word established the political supremacy. Understand children? Very important. In the beginning, they were British or British to follow peaceful trade policy in India. After that, they took the advantages of political situation in India. After that, English were established their political supremacy in India. Understand children? See here. Merchants in countries of eastern aspect means ambition our mother tongue china nidondille eastern country ಅಂತ ನಮ್ಮ ಗ್ರಾಮವನ್ನು ಅವರು ಅಭಿವೃದ್ಧಿ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋದು ambition ಅನ್ನ ಹೊಂದಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಯಾವ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ in like english what changes have to aspire trade in countries of eastern countries and also they were established east india company english east india company in the year 1600 common era 1600 common era they were established the east india company they were established east india company india english east india company they were established in the year 1600 common era they were established the english east india company understand very important this date here english east india company was established in the year of 1600 we can call the english east india company in india and also they established their trade in india with the permission of vina eljabar understand after this 1600 they were stopped their trade with india in the permission of Vino Elizabeth who took the permission the English merchants were took the permission the Queen of England Vino Elizabeth when in the year 1600 common era after they were start the trade with India after this in the beginning East India Company ships were landed in the Surat ports in the beginning the English merchants ships were landed in the port of Surat first in the beginning English merchants ships are landed in port of Surat understand first English merchants were ships were all landed in port of Surat after Sir Thomas Rowe very important Sir Thomas Roy Sir Thomas Roy he was the viceroy of English he was the viceroy of English Sir Thomas Rowe visited the port of Mughal Empire Jhangi he visited the port of Mughal Emperor Emperor Jahangir Senior. Mughal Emperor Jahangir. Sir Thomas Roy visited to court of Mughal Emperor. His name is Jahangir in the year 1615 Common Era. In the year 1615 Common Era. 615 Common Era. Sir Thomas Roy was visited to court of Mughal Emperor. Emperor Jahangir in the year of 1615 Common Era. That time had obtained the permission to trade in Surat and took after visit they took the permission from the Jahangir to start the trade in Surat. To start the trade in Surat. Understand who gave the permission? The Mughal Emperor Jahangir was given the permission to start the trade in Surat in the year 1615 Common Era. After this, later trade centers were established. After this, the English were started the or established the trade centers in India. Which are the trade centers of English? Centers of English. Very important. Name the trade centers of English. First one is they were established trade centers in Agra. In Agra. Second one trade centers of English were that is Ahmedabad. Next one is Bruch. Bruch. And also after they established centers in Calcutta and Madras. Calcutta. Madras and Bombay, present Mumbai. Understand? English were established the trade centers first Agra, second Ahmedabad and Bruch and Calcutta and Madras and Bombay. And very important Calcutta. Calcutta is the capital of English. Understand? Calcutta is the capital of English. See children, which are the trade centers of English? Agra, Ahmedabad, Bruch, Abruj, Calcutta, Madras and Mumbai. It means Bombay. Understand? Calcutta is the capital of English. Understand children? These are the trading centers of British or English in India. Next. They were developed their trade in India. Gradually, the profit of East India Company is day by day was increased. The profit of the English English, East, East, India, Company, Company, Increase. Understand? Day by day, East India's, East English, East India Company's profit was increased in India. They obtained the permission to the trade without any tax in the Bengal province. Understand? After this, they were obtained the permission. They gained the permission to trade without any tax in the province of Bengal. Understand? This is very, very important. They obtained this achieve the permission. The permission without any tax in the province of Bengal. Province of Bengal, very, very important. After 1650, the East India Company was increased the profit day by day. After this, they were descended to the obtained or achieved or gained the permission without paying any, without any tax in the province of Bengal. It is, and also the present Bengal is Bihar and Odisha. And the present Bengal is present Bengal, Bihar and Odisha. And also in Agra from the Mughal Emperor Farrukhsia. Was given by Farrukhsia Established the fort, Very good.